Colleen, DIYer behind lemonthistle.com. Today, I'm going to show you how to make a unique towel rack for your bathroom using free pallet wood. On the last episode, I showed you how to disassemble a pallet. For this project, you'll need one disassembled pallet. You'll need sandpaper, I use 60 grit, something to mark your wood for cutting, a tape measure, hooks, 1-inch screws, rubber gloves and stain, a clear coat, colored paint, and a drill with a small drill bit. The first step is to decide how big you'd like your towel rack to be. I've decided that I'd like mine to be 2 feet high by 1 foot and 8 inches long. Measure and mark your cuts, and you can cut your pallet wood using a chop saw, a circular saw, or even a hand saw. You'll also need 2 shorter pieces for the backing that are 2 inches smaller than your towel rack will be wide. So that makes mine 1 foot 6 inches. After you've cut them, you need to sand them down with a 60 grit sander. You don't want to sand them down so much to get rid of the pallet wood look, but just enough to get rid of the really sharp edges, any paint that might be on them, and any frayed edges from where you cut. So wearing your gloves, all you need to do is wipe the stain on with a rag. Once your stain is dry, you're going to want to protect it with a clear coat. I used a spray clear coat, but you can also use a brush on if that's what you have on hand. This is going to protect it from all the bathroom humidity. So once everything's dry, it's time to assemble. Lay out your backing pieces and decide how you'd like the pieces to look. Have one backing piece up near the top and one near the bottom for support. Once you're happy with how it looks, you can flip it over and start drilling it together. Depending on the thickness of your backing wood, you might need longer or shorter screws. Once you're finished drilling, you can turn it over and we'll decide where we'd like our hooks to go. This is going to be the top of my towel rack and this is going to be my bottom, so I can start lining up my hooks. Most hooks come like this with holes that you can screw directly into. The ones I'm going to be using are antique, so the screw is directly on it, so I need to drill pilot holes first. And then I need to screw these in by hand. Once all your hooks are in nice and tight, you're done. You can leave it like this, or you can paint something with your colored paint. You could paint a saying or draw a picture, but I kind of like the way that it is like this. So this is completely ready to hang on your bathroom wall.